My name is Lana McKenzie, and I won $2 million in the lottery, but then got scammed. So where my story really starts is in British Columbia, Canada. Me and my husband, Shannon, we have Jackson, who's 3 years and 3 quarters, and then we have Cooper, who's on the way. But we discover that Cooper, there is some complications in the pregnancy. When they did the ultrasounds, they discovered that he did have an enlarged kidney. So I was being monitored, and then when he was born, it was discovered that he did need to have surgery. It's microsurgery that they're doing on this 8-month-old. That was an incredible emotional to hand your baby over to a doctor. And so he was in surgery for 3 hours and 45 minutes. Like, you trust that these doctors are gonna fix your baby. He stayed at the hospital for 3 days and he started getting better right away, just much better. And the doctors were amazing. We had amazing care. We wanted to support the hospital in any way that we could. And they do a lot of fundraisers. Twice a year, they do this lottery. They have a lot of sponsors who donate the houses. They donate the cars. I bought 3 tickets. It's about a 2-month window that they sell the tickets and then they do the draw. We bought the tickets to help the foundation, but at the same time, I was like, oh, maybe I'll win a set of luggage. Maybe I'll win a car, at least a $50 gift certificate. It's the day of the draw. My colleague said, hey, did you buy your ticket? So I went and over to my desk, I checked my phone and it looked like I'd missed 3 calls. And it was a number I didn't recognize. I checked the website to see if they had uploaded what the ticket number was, and the numbers matched.
Oh my God! Oh my God.
We won $2.2 million and I was just like floating on a cloud. It was just so surreal. In an instant, your whole life changes and it's like the most best feeling ever. You're jumping up and down. I called my husband and I was like, we won, we won. And he's like, what? Oh my God. And because we're in Canada, it's tax-free. It's like the most amazing feeling ever. You don't have the financial stress that you had. You feel like you're free from that daily grind. It's overwhelming at first. I took a couple days off work. Then once the dust settles and you think, okay, what should we do? Shannon shopped for a boat. I got the hockey mom van. He wanted me to get this luxury SUV, fancy car, and I was like, nah, that's too cliche. I want my hockey mom van that I can pack the kids in and everything. So we both got new vehicles and we ended up getting the house of our dreams. I mean, 2.2 is a lot of money. But once you buy the house, you buy the cars and stuff, you kind of want to set yourself up for the future. You kind of have to really look at what you value. You know, what do you want in your life that you want to enhance? If you don't sit down and do that, then you just spend and it just goes. For us, it was about having opportunities for our kids and kind of building generational wealth, making it better for them when they get older. I started looking into different investment avenues. I took a course on different private lending opportunities and how you can facilitate loaning your money out and the returns that you would get. I had a friend talk to me a little bit about an investment opportunity that she had been doing quite successfully for the last 4 years. Private lending through short-term bridge loans. So it was a mortgage broker that had these people looking for funds because they were selling one property and then buying a new property. So in the meantime, they need this short-term bridge financing. This company was offering investors quite high returns to loan your money to this mortgage broker to loan out to people that needed this short-term funding. I asked my lawyer and my lawyer said, just check it out with the financial regulator, like make sure this company has a mortgage broker license. So I checked that, license was all good. I didn't take this lightly. I wanted to really research my investment. It looked good to me, and so we signed up. With private lending, you have to have your money ready right then. It's a quick process. So all these deals come up for short-term bridge loans. So you get these emails of these deals that says this one is coming up for this amount. I tried 60 grand. It was an 8-week investment and I got $8,000 after that. So it was good. I invested $200,000 on this one deal that came up. I got $36,000 within 12 weeks. After that, me and my husband talked. We were mortgage free on our house. Why don't we just take a small home equity line of credit? We'll, you know, lend it out with this. It becomes a tax write-off because we're borrowing to invest, so it's 100% tax deductible. So we took some money against the house. We took the last of the lottery funds. All in, we put in around $500,000.
That's a lot of money.
I wanted to make everything better for us, and my world came crashing down. It's awful what's happened. Things started not getting paid. And then we're starting to ask, so when is our payout gonna be? When is our payout? The guy starts emailing saying, yeah, we'll be paying you next week, next week, next week. The person who runs the company, he's kind of a charming guy and was like, yeah, yeah, you know, and my husband even talked to him and said, yeah, yeah, we'll be paying you. And I think he knew he needed to start engaging with the investors. And so he started doing these Zooms, but nobody could chat with him. It was a one-way Zoom.
We 100% will pay you back.
And so I'm looking into this company a little bit more, and it really seems like it is not a business as we thought, and it's controlled by this one mortgage broker. So what's going on here? Like, what's really going on?
Look at this. First the guy says we're gonna get paid in March, now it says April 23rd. What?
This is bad.
I know that I'm not gonna be able to make everybody happy. Guys, I understand that. But what I don't respect is when people say things that are untrue.
Yeah.
We can't find him?
I get these messages, but I've tried to call and the number is out of service. What are we supposed to do?
Guys, you're gonna get paid back. Everybody's gonna see their money.
Do we call somebody? Do we call the police? What do we?
I don't know. I'll start looking up that, I guess, because I don't know.
That's everything. This is bad. This is bad. This is bad.
We try to contact, and there's just limited contact. And then he keeps saying, we're going to pay out. We're going to be doing these Zooms.
Look, guys, don't call me, don't text me, don't email me.
My friend texted me and said nobody knows where he is, and he's left the country, and there's a civil suit started. The air just came out of me. I was like, everything is gone. It was just like fear, and like, just like a ton of bricks hit me, because I've been trying so hard to build up for a family and just to, you know, not be a broke lottery winner. I was so ashamed that we had invested in thinking that it was something good. I couldn't talk about it for like weeks. I had to take, you know, a couple of days off work because I couldn't even work. I was like, devastated to realize that it's all fabricated. The offices that he had were vacated. The courts can't find him. The receivership can't find him. They're still doing the funds flow analysis. It looks like things were put from this bank account to that bank account to crypto. We don't know. So we've been scammed, like all the money that we put in. It adds up to about $800,000 that's owed. There's 5 civil suits against him, and there's just so much unknown. There's a lot of anger, resentment, because he's screwed us and many others. There is no due diligence you can do against a bad person, but the returns were so good with his investment, and if it seems too good to be true, it probably is. There's over 700 investors with over $250 million missing. My lottery dream turned into my lottery nightmare. He took away a lot. That's the hardest part, is that it feels like he stole our future.